Welcome back, treasures. Today, I'm going to be turning this space in my kitchen into a simple kitchen altar. Now, while I don't consider myself to be a kitchen witch, I did want to bring some more spiritual energy into my kitchen, and this is the best space I have for that. I also have a couple of craft projects lined up for you, starting with this old cauldron mug that kind of busted in the microwave. I wanted to be able to use this to put some plants in, but I didn't want any further damage, so I decided to paint it and then use some enamel to protect it against water. I also have an excess amount of chopsticks at my house. So for the next craft, I'm going to make a pentagram out of these chopsticks. However, they're a little bit light for the space that I have against my blinds, so I wanted to darken them up. Very simple to do that with a little bit of wood stain and an old sock. Now it will stain your hands, so be careful and wear some gloves, unless you just want some weird spots on your hands. Then don't wear the gloves. After the stain dried, I just used a little bit of glue to glue each stick to the end of another in a shape that ended up being a five-pointed star, which is a pentagram, and it turned out wonderful. Next, I was at Hobby Lobby and they had all of their fall decor 75% off. So I got this little cornucopia of pumpkins for about $2. I am so excited for it to be in all of the future fall decor I have as well. Also at Hobby Lobby on the clearance, I found this really weird floral thing, so it called to me. It has to go on the altar as well. Before I placed anything on the altar, I wanted to cleanse the space. So I did this with smoke. I've done it with sound before. You could do it with maybe some blessed water, some moon water. I like smoke. I find that it gets into all of the cracks very easily, and I feel that connection to it. So that's what I use. Then I hung the pentagram from the ceiling using fishing line so it would have this kind of dangle effect. And then I just put the items in a space that felt right. I got this candle on the Hobby Lobby clearance as well. It is cran apple cider. It smells so good. And it has a very unique patterning on the outside and kind of a layer of colors that really work with the energy that I was trying to bring into this space. I have some eggshells here that I just have because it's easy to wash them and put them there to dry, and having them there for that extra protection is nice as well. I really love how everything turned out and how it looks and how things work with each other. I just need a little bit of water here, and then I have all of the elements working. together. It will be a space that I continue to build onto, and I hope that you will come back and join me to see how this continues to grow. Thank you so much. I hope you have a blessed day, and until next time, keep crafting.